It's finally here. Over 2 years later, the new DJI Action 2 is out, and how does it compare to the GoPro 10? In today's video, we're gonna find out.
And what's up, guys? I'm here on the beach. This is 4K 30 on the Action 2, and this is 5K 30 on the GoPro 10.
So right off the bat, I'm loving that uber ultra wide field of view on the Action 2, and usually for an action camera, you're gonna want it super wide angle.
So quick little audio comparison. This is audio on the Action 2, and this is audio on the GoPro 10. Which one is sounding better?
The audio sounded better on the GoPro, and the Action 2 had that screen module attached, so it has those extra mics. I'll show you how the audio compares between the two modules in just a minute.
So how's dynamic range? It's super bright here on the beach. How am I getting exposed? And that bright sunlight behind me.
Honestly, they're both looking good, nice colors, and great dynamic range.
Go for a quick little stabilization test.
They both look super smooth, although DJI can lock that horizon level with no media mod needed. Let me show you how awesome that feature is.
All right, and now this is with each camera's horizon lock, leveling, stabilization, soft, or whatever. Now, no max lens mod on the GoPro, but as I swivel the camera around, how is each camera doing that horizon leveling? I swivel it down here, and over here, and up. Which one is looking better?
So I just love that the horizon lock feature is built right into the Action 2. Plus, it's keeping a wider field of view, which is pretty incredible. So basically, I can mount and orientate the camera in almost any position and not have to worry about leveling out the shot. It's one of my favorite features.
So while both of these cameras can do the 4K 120, which is just insane for an action camera, I'll show you those samples in just a second. We do have that higher resolution of 5K on the GoPro. So can you guys actually notice any clarity or sharpness, resolution differences?
So honestly, it's pretty funny. I like the clarity on the DJI side better. Just look at the bubbles or the tiny grains of sand. It's soft and smudgy on the GoPro, but it's looking much sharper on the DJI side. It's honestly pretty nutty that these little action cameras can record 4K 120. It's just awesome to have. Both sides look good, possibly a tad sharper on the DJI, and it's a bit smoother too. See how the GoPro has some wobbles. Here's another 4K 120 as that new Nan robot rips through the sand. And by the way, that scooter video's coming soon. I'm liking that wider angle on the Action 2. Here's a little cinematic sample, straightening out those fisheye edges. And you can see just how much wider the DJI lens is, which is pretty cool. But one downside, I zoomed out here so you can see the major distortion on those edges. It can be a little bit sometimes, maybe even a bit dizzying for some people. It's just something to be aware of. I went down to the pool at night, and in these low light samples, 4K on each, they both are looking pretty bad. I'll say it in almost every video. Action cameras are usually rough at nighttime. I'd avoid it if you can. Now, I think if I had to pick, it'd be the GoPro side. It's slightly brighter in the shadows, plus its white balance is a bit more real to life. So the Action 2 has this magnetic lanyard. It's really awesome for hands-free POV shots, but I feel like I've seen it before. Make sure you guys are subscribed and you come back for my upcoming comparison versus the Insta360 Go 2. I just love magnets.
Battery life on both of these cameras are kind of trash. I've only been out here less than 45 minutes. Action 2 without the add-on base, whatever, is already at what, 33%? GoPro's at 47. These were fully charged. Kind of terrible battery life on each.
Yeah, so honestly, both of them are kind of weak in the battery life department. GoPro looks to be releasing this Enduro battery soon to help extend battery life. I guess we'll wait and see on that. Now, speaking of battery, something to mention, if you want a spare battery for a GoPro, it's gonna be like 15-ish bucks on Amazon, pretty cheap. If you want a spare battery for this guy, you can get the power combo, but this thing is going for 75 bucks. That's pretty steep.
All right, quick little mic check and comparison. With the no screen power combo, we only have one mic. It's right there on the camera itself. With the screen, we actually have four mics. There's three down there on the screen and then one up there on the top. So four versus one microphone. Can you hear or spot any differences? Audio check, 1, 2, 3, 4, 360. Audio. There we go.
Snapping a couple of quick photos. DJI has that larger sensor, but funny enough, GoPro has more megapixels, 23.6 versus 12. In daylight and the bright contrast scenes, they look pretty similar, but I think I like the GoPro shots just a tad more.
So the Action 2 has this digital zoom. It's basically just a crop in up to 4 times. And
Yeah, it's kind of gross. I don't think I'd ever recommend you using it.
Here's that shot zoomed out. DJI has wider angle again. Then here's that 4x shot. And for GoPro, I just cropped it in. Both are kind of trashy. If you want to zoom in, just use a smartphone. And a hilarious newbie mistake. When I was snapping these selfie shots, apparently the Action 2 was still zoomed in from those previous shots. So oopsie. Stepping inside for lower light, the DJI goes pretty soft and kind of yucky. Now I would have thought maybe larger pixel size on the Action 2 would produce better low light shots, but oddly this doesn't seem to be true. It might come down to software processing, but GoPro clearly wins in these low light shots. Now there are some cons you should know about the Action 2, but right before I get to those, big thanks to this video sponsor, Artlist. All the music you're hearing in this video is from their website, which offers unlimited song downloads and one universal royalty-free license. They have a wide selection of music, sound effects, and even stock footage at artgrid.io. I like using their video theme categories, helps me narrow down quickly to find the best tracks that fit the style of video. Use my link down below and get 2 extra months for free. Huge thanks again, Artlist. So a few more pros and cons. The haptic motor built into the Action 2 is incredible. It's awesome for navigating the menus, and now I don't want any action camera that doesn't have one inside. That touchscreen, though, it's pretty small, it's OLED, it's surprisingly bright, and the user interface is pretty intuitive and quick to navigate. Built into the camera module is some storage, about 22 gigs of usable space. With the power or the screen module, there's an SD slot for expandable storage. It's cool to have.
This is pretty cool. When you connect it via USB to your computer, it shows up as two different drives, your internal and SD, and then you can access files from there. Pretty nice. This is a really slick feature. When you have the two connected, an SD card, you tap that, and then now you can check your storage space on the internal and the SD format and stuff like that. But check this little feature out. You can export all your clips from the internal and move them over to the SD card. I love that little feature. Very handy.
Now, I did find that the process of copying those clips over to the SD could take quite a while. I still really appreciate the feature. One random annoyance. I turned the camera sideways and hanging it off the balcony for the sick ocean sunset time lapse, but it recorded it vertically, and this happens with auto or locked orientation, on or off. Now, I'm not sure what I'm missing here. Comment below if you guys know a trick. How do I turn the camera sideways and then still record a flat, level horizon and time lapse? Is it not possible because maybe the sensor orientation? Though I can still crop in on that sensor in video mode to keep that locked horizon, so why can't I turn that on in photo or time lapse mode? And when you first get the camera, you have to connect it to the app and register or whatever, and I really don't like it when they force us to do that. Also, there's no built-in replaceable screen protector. So remember, these things are in action shots, and when your GoPro smashes into the ground and this thing gets cracked, you can just pop it off and replace it. Not sure what you're gonna do with this. Now, I've asked myself, modular is super cool and fun, and I love magnets, but is it really needed? What's the point? It all depends, I think, on what the person is gonna be shooting. For example, if you're flying FPV, this tiny, lightweight, and small camera is powerful, and it might be a better fit than using a GoPro, let's say. Or if you want that hands-free POV lanyard shot, this is way easier and faster to mount than a heavy GoPro. But there's plenty of downsides as well, like battery life. This guy alone doesn't last super long, and if you attach it for extended battery, that helps, but if you wanted a spare, that's gonna be, what, $75, where the GoPro batteries are way cheaper, so that's one downside. Another complaint is that the camera itself, it's waterproof, which is awesome, but if you wanna mount it on like the screen or the power module, these are not waterproof, oddly enough. Which, if you remember, the original modular action camera from Insta360 1R, this thing, even with those like pins and the battery and all that, this was waterproof as is, so they could do it. So I think the big question is, which action camera am I gonna grab when I go out for those action scooting whatever shots? And I'm still testing them all out, but I think I might grab the DJI Action 2 over the GoPro 10. I just really like its stabilization and maintaining that ultra wide field of view or horizon lock if I need it. We'll see if battery life just kills my workflow, but I have a feeling it should last me long enough. Plus, I love that modular mounting system, so I can have it out on a pole or clamp to my dirt bike and then snap it off and pop it onto my lanyard for a quick POV shot. I like popping it from one to the next. It's pretty cool and efficient. Now, pricing on all of these is pretty expensive. Which one do you guys think has the most bang for the buck? Now, if possible, use my affiliate links down below to help support me and the channel. Drop any questions you have down in the comments and I'll try my best to respond. Now, next up, check out my GoPro 10 in-depth review or maybe this other action camera comparison. I'll see you guys in the next video.
There they go.